Yo, what up, Toolmaker? Today I'm going to go over buses, groups, sends, returns in Pro Tools. If you need help with Ableton or FL Studio, I got videos for those up here. Groups and buses can help organize a session. They can help glue things together in a mix. Overall, they can just help you work more efficiently. So with that, let's go ahead and dive in. So what can you do with groups in Pro Tools? To start, you can group drums together and background vocals. Groups are great in a scenario if you mic'd an entire drum kit and then you've set your levels and then you just want to lower the overall level of the drums. Instead of lowering each fader one by one, you can just put it in a group. You can also create groups within groups in Pro Tools. So if you have multiple kicks or snares and you have them layered and you just want to lower the overall level, you can do that with a group. So this is how you set it up. So you can highlight all the tracks that you want in a group. And then you can either use Command G or you can come up to track. Inside the Create Group box, you have what's available and you have currently what's in the group. These are really easy to add or remove. Groups also default where you can control the volume and the mutes. Your clips are also grouped and can be moved around. You can crop them. You can add fades. This can be really useful when mixing. Down here on the left is where your groups are going to be. You can name your group right here. Down here on the left-hand side, you also have all. So if you ever want to put all your tracks in a group where you maybe want to move around your session, you can do that. It's really easy to turn off and on your groups. All you got to do is just highlight your group. Also, another word of advice up here on tracks, because sometimes if you're messing around with the groups, you may turn off and have your tracks disappear. And that's because these are deselected. So you can turn them right back on and you can see your tracks again. When mixing, I definitely recommend groups. It's really easy to do drops and fades with them. You can also get back to your group at any time if you need to make adjustments by just clicking here. Next is using a bus in Pro Tools. This allows you to route a signal from one track to another location. You can use a bus for outboard gear also, but in this tutorial, I'm just going to go over submixes and effect sends. One thing I do the majority of the time is I bus my drums together. This allows me to glue them together with compression. I also use this technique with background vocals as well. Another good example is if you have a bigger session, say for instance you have four background vocals and you put six plugins on each of those background vocals, that puts you at 24 plugins. So a lot of times that's going to slow down your computer. What you can do instead is you could just bus all those to a group and you could just process just the bus. So now you just have six plugins versus the 24. To bus in Pro Tools, it's pretty easy. First, create an empty auxiliary track. You can do that by holding Command Shift N on a Mac, or you can just go up to track. I'm going to do a stereo track. I'm going to name this drums. Now I'm going to choose a bus. I'm going to go ahead and bus this to 1 and 2. Now I'm going to route all the drum tracks I want to my bus. This top one is my input. This is the output. So that's how I'm sending the signal. So now these four tracks are being sent to my bus. I still have control independently of my drums, but if I'd like, I can lower the overall volume by this one fader. Now I can process all my drums together on this one fader. Next, we're going to set up a send and return. It's very similar. We're going to start by setting up an auxiliary track. For this one, I'm going to select bus 11 and 12. I'm going to name this reverb. We're going to add the reverb. Now, instead of our output, we are going to go to our send track right here. This fader right here is going to control the amount of reverb that we put on this snare.
When you go moving fast, you stay your sister. Now I'm at the park with my son from another girl over 10 years ago.
So if you have reverb on your vocal and then you put an EQ right after the reverb, now you're EQing your vocal and your reverb together. This is what you don't want. Putting this on a send allows you to process just the reverb. Now you can do more to your reverb without it affecting your vocal. So that's a quick summary of buses, groups, sends, and returns in Pro Tools. So if you like content like this, please feel free to like and subscribe. Other than that, peace out.